Sometimes I be in the mood. Smoke to calm my nerves, I know sometimes I get at you. Like you don't wanna blame it, me and you go get into it. And you say you gon' leave, my stubborn ass tell you to do it. Acting like I never push you through. Acting like if I tell you bring that cash, you ain't gon' do it. You keep it 1,000 like the tags on all my shoes.
Hello you guys, welcome to my channel. This is my first YouTube video and you guys will be making chicken and broccoli pasta with me. First things first, you want to put your chicken in a bowl and rinse it off with either cold water or vinegar. The next thing you want to do is cut off all the fat and anything that looks unpleasant to eat. I like to cut my chicken in tiny cubes. I do not like them big pieces of meat in my pasta. Going in with all my seasonings, garlic powder, seasoning salt, parsley flakes, black pepper, flavor got everything seasoning, and Cajun seasoning. Make sure you season that up real good. Mix it all up. Here go Quattro greedy self rushing me. I like to go in with a teaspoon of minced garlic to give it, you know, that flavor. Add some more of my seasons. You season it to your liking. I like my stuff to have flavor. When you put your diced chicken tenders in there, make sure that the fire is on low. You do not want to dry out your chicken too fast. You want it to be nice, juicy, and tender. You tell me you want. While the chicken is cooking up, I'm going to go ahead and put on some water for the noodles so that that can come to a boil while the chicken is cooking. You take me away. Thank you. my sauce, I'm going to go ahead and go in with the heavy whipping cream, Parmesan cheese. Okay, so I thought the broccoli was too big, so I went and chopped it up. To steam the broccoli, I'm going to add a slice of butter and a cup of water. Make sure you put that top on there so you know it can do the thing. For the sauce, I like to add a slice of butter in there because you know I like my pasta real creamy. You want to also make sure that your sauce is on low because you do not want the cheese or the milk to burn. Once the chicken is fully cooked, you want to add it to your sauce and let it come to a boil. Yep, throw all that juice up in there too. Make sure to give it a good stir. I like to use a whisk. I probably should have been using a spoon because all the chicken got up in there, but it's, you know, it's okay. Once your water comes to a boil, you want to put your fettuccine noodles in there and make sure that you stir it up once you put it in there because you do not want your noodles to stick to the bottom of the pot. You are everything, and everything is you. Once your broccoli is all steamed up, you want to add it to the sauce and let it come to a boil. Make sure to keep stirring everything around because you do not want your sauce to burn and you do not want your noodles to stick to the bottom of the pot. Taste as you go and season to your liking. Now we're on to the garlic bread. I made my own special sauce and you know it's gonna be fire. I got my garlic powder, minced garlic, parsley flakes, and avocado oil. Make sure you have a small little bowl to put it in and a little brush. sure to taste test your noodles to make sure that they are completely done. And then you add it into the sauce. Season it one last time to make sure that we flavor it up, and make sure to season it to your liking. And then I like to take the rest of the Italian cheese that I used for the garlic bread and just throw the rest up in there. Stir everything together and it's magic, just like that. Okay, and we got the garlic bread finna go into the oven. Here's the final finished product of everything, and I made extra crispy garlic bread, and I did go back in and put some of that sauce on top of it, and it tastes so bomb, and the bread is super soft. Doesn't that look lovely? This is my first YouTube video, y'all, so bear with me. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And comment down below what y'all want me to make next, because you know I will do it.
You know I'm always love you.